Hello students, welcome to the 8th lecture of Java programming. These one are the contents of lesson plan for programming in Java BCA 5th semester as per the syllabus of IK Gujral Punjab Technical University Jalandhar. I am going to discuss about Java support system and Java environment today. This one is the syllabus. You can see the contents over here also. 502 is the code. You can check the contents here. This one is the first topic, fundamentals of object-oriented programming. We have completed this one. Second one is the Java evolution. I am going to complete this topic today, Java support system and Java environment. It's the last topic of this chapter, Java evolution. Let us start with the topic Java for BCA 5th semester according to IK Gujral Punjab Technical University Jalandhar. It's unit 2nd, Java Evolution, lesson number 5, Java support system and Java environment. First of all, what is the meaning of Java support system? Basically, what contents are supporting to Java? That's Java support system. Let us discuss one by one. We have already completed with the operations of Java, some basic programs of Java in Java Lab lecture also, and Java enabled browser in previous lectures, and also the various support system for Java. Let's study about these support systems. First of all, list of Java support system. Internet connection is required, web browser is required, then web server is required, web browser is required, HTML is required, applet tag is required, Java code, then bytecode, proxy server and mail server. These are the 9 contents. I am going to explain one by one what is the meaning of this. First of all, internet connection. Local computers should be connected to the internet. It's the first requirement. Means internet requirement is there for Java support system. That's first step. Second one is web server, a program that accept request for information and send required documents. You already know about web server. Your maximum students are using internet. And what is the meaning of that particular server, a program? Basically, I am talking in terms of a program that accept request for the information and send required documents. Suppose I am a client and you are server. I am sending some content to you, some request to you, and you process that request and then send it back to me. It's basically client server architecture. These contents you can also study inside your computer system architecture and also inside networking. What is the meaning of client and what is the meaning of server? You can do that. You can study one book by Andrew S. Tannenbaum and also one more book, that is Barrows S. Frozen. Next one is a web browser. A program that provides access to www. Now, what is the meaning of www? It's World Wide Web. And runs Java applets. I am concentrating not only on Java applets, but I am talking here about Java applets. But you can execute each and every content on a web browser. Maybe it's audio content, maybe it's video content, or your text content, maybe form designing is there. Submission of the content is there and you can retrieve messages from that. All the contents can be run using your web browser. Next one is HTML. If I am talking about HTML, it's not only the HTML language, but it is the basic language for creating hypertext for the web. But there are too many other languages. For example, if I am talking about JavaScript, jQuery, VBScript, your Java language, and your JSP, many languages are there. Too much languages. It's a bundle of languages in which you can do your web content. You can design your web content. Even advanced by default platforms are there. Maybe Angular, Node, and React. All the contents are there. Next one is applet tag. For placing Java applets in HTML documents, this tag is required. If you would like to place the particular content inside your web page, then applet tag is required. Now, what about Java code? Java code obviously is required. Java code is used for defining Java applets. We can separately discuss about the applet classes. Or I have already discussed in one lecture that what is the meaning of applet and how can you design applet. Every content was there inside that particular lecture. I think the previous one. The seventh content is bytecode. It's also the part of your Java support system. Compiled Java code that is referred to in the applet tag and transferred to the user computer, that's bytecode. Now what about proxy server? An intermediate server between the requesting client workstation and the original server. If I am talking in terms of client and server, inside one proxy server is there. It's typically implemented by ensuring security. Only for security purposes, proxy server is there so that the server can send exactly the same information, whatever is required, to the same person who requests that particular services. That's why this proxy server is required. Next one is mail server, a computer system that facilitates, means supports, exchange, that is sending and receiving of electron mails across network. That's mail server. In previous video, I discussed about one topic, that is SMTP, and one more, I think POP, post office protocol. You know about that content. Now what about Java environment? There are large number of development tools and hundreds of classes and methods. Yes, there are there. Too much content of Java is available. The development tools are the part of system known as Java Development Kit. One content is there, one broader content is there, I can say Java Development Kit. It's also one of the important questions as far as your PTU examination is concerned. And what is the meaning of JDK and explain its working. Or you can say JRE, JVM, all the contents are there. Maybe the differentiating factor between JDK, JRE and JVM, whether they are equal or some differentiating factors are there. What are the functionality of JDK, JRE and JVM? Whether it's a single system or a separate system of instructions is there. All the contents may be there in examination. And the classes and methods are the part of Java standard library. These are the part of Java standard library. Also known as API, maximum people are known about API, application programming interface. But JSL is also the name for that. That's Java standard library. Later on in this lecture at the end, I will discuss about API. What is the meaning of API? And what are the various packages available inside application programming interface? For example, AWT, applet, networking, input, output, utility, language support system, various contents are there inside API. At the end of the lecture, I will discuss about this. Now, first of all, JDK. We have to discuss about JDK also. JDK comes with the collection of tools that are used for developing and running Java programs. Basically, these are the collection of tools. Various tools are there inside the Java program. And what about these tools or what about these programs? Following is the list of those Java programs. Or you can say tools, collection of tools. Following is the list of those collection of tools. These tools are AppletWare for viewing Java applets, JavaC for compiling Java program, Java act as Java interpreter if I am writing Java only. JavaC is for compilation. First of all, you have to use JavaC, then you have to use Java only. It means first of all you have to compile the program for errors. While executing the program, you have to write Java only. It means then interpreter is working. Then Java H, suppose you have to include some of the header files similar to C language, then you can use Java H. For C header files, you can also include C header files. Java Doc for creating a HTML document inside Java. JDP is a Java debugger for debugging the system or for checking the system for errors. Let's discuss one by one about these contents. First of all, Applet View. It enables us to run Java applets without actually using Java enabled web browser. Web browser is not required. I think yesterday you see about the lecture, inside the lecture, that how I run the applet. I am running the applet without using internet. You can run the similar type of content without using web browser. Applet Viewer basically provides the facility to run the applet without using your web browser. But you can execute inside the web browser, but without web browser you can also execute. Second one is Java C. It's a compiler, basically it's a Java compiler which translates Java source code to bytecode files that the interpreter can understand. Before using interpreter, you have to use Java C, that is compiler of Java. Now next one is Java interpreter, which runs applets and applications by reading and interpreting bytecode files. Now bytecode, basically the conversion of bytecode lies here, Java C. Java source code to bytecode. Java C convert this content into bytecode, and later on Java will read this. That's why Java C comes first, compiler comes first. Basically it convert the program into bytecode, then Java read that bytecode for errors. Then Java H, it will produce header files for the use of your native methods. Now what about Java Doc? Java Doc creates HTML format documentation from Java source code files. It's for HTML formation. You can implement this later on in the, I think, end of the near about your this book, we will use Java Doc or HTML document. These are the introductory sessions, introductory, you can say, lectures about Java language, not the detailed study. Because these are complete books regarding each and every topic. If I am talking about applet, it's complete bundle of, there are lots of program inside Java applet viewer. Java C and Java, it's okay. Java head, it's also okay. But Java doc is also again a big huge topic. Similarly, JDB, it's okay. Java debugger helps to find error in our programs. The next one is API. Now, what is the meaning of API? Application Program Interface. It's a full form. JSL or API includes hundreds of classes and methods grouped into several functional packages. Most commonly used packages are language support package, utility, then input output, networking, AWT and applet. Let's discuss one by one about these packages. First of all, language support package, it's a basic feature of Java. There collection of classes and objects for those basic features. Basic feature, for example, suppose I have to add just a single program, or addition, subtraction, multiplication, or simple programs are there, not the complex features. Means the use content is not there. For example, multiple classes, inheritance content, polymorphism content, this type of content is not there inside this basic content. That's why it's known as language support package. Means basic package is there. Now, what is the meaning of utility? Utility means add-on features or additional functionality provision to the classes. For example, data and time functionality. It's one feature there are too many other features also. Suppose from one class to another class you have to import the content, or suppose from one bundle there are too many bundles, 3 or 4 bundles or 5 bundles or 10 bundles are there, you have to combine that content. Utility packages are basically used for that additional functionality. Input output, it's a simple to enter the value and to display the content, means the entry from the user, input or output you are displaying the content. So collection of packages required for input output functions in Java. For example, scanner class we have already used. Basically we are doing the things presently and we are not going into the deeper section of Java. While we enter into the deeper section of a Java class, then we can understand more about input output packages. Then networking, still this content is also pending. When we have to connect two systems using Java program, it may be using internet or without using internet. Suppose wired system is there, two programs are there, with the help of programming content you are connecting one system with another system, you are sending messages, you are receiving the messages using internet. Presently I am talking in terms of internet, to communicate with another system using Java programming via internet. We need such packages, that is known as networking package. This package is too much important, that is AWT. AWT is basically for designing purposes, to design a form, button, text boxes, labels, combo box, option button, check box. Means suppose I am checking one form, suppose the form of UGC net or a form of army recruitment or any other one form is there. Suppose you can see all the contents inside the form. First of all, numbers are there, then label is there, text box is there, then at last submit button is there. Everything can be designed using AWT in Java, used for designing purposes. For example, form designing, you can say graphical user interface. Then applet, we have already completed with applets, but later on special classes will also be there regarding applets. Basically it's a set of classes that allow us to create Java applets. Summary is not the single point. There are too many other points. Java support system, if I am talking in terms of detailed content, Java support system is there. Then the various list of Java support system, these contents are there. If I am talking in terms of summary, then Java environment, inside Java environment I discussed about JDK and JSL and various contents inside JDK, that's collection of tools and various others. Thanks for watching my video.